Indonesia has the floor.
Peace be with you.
Honorable delegates, the region of Asia-Pacific experiences over 70% of the world natural disaster. It is also predicted that the intensity and frequency of disaster in this region will be increased in the decades ahead, exacerbated by climate change and poor land management. In Southeast Asia, Indonesia has an important role in the establishment of the Asian Agreement on Disaster Management and Emergency Response, and the Asian Coordinating Center for Humanitarian Assistance on Disaster Management. During the third global platform on DRR in 2011, Indonesia received the first Global Champion in Disaster Risk Reduction Award and became a regional role model in disaster risk reduction and mitigation effort after the devastating tsunami. In Indonesia, disaster management reform was initiated in 2007, and the National Agency for Disaster Management was appointed as a ministerial-level institution to implement the national policies on this sector. Following this mandate, Indonesia passed the Government Regulation on Disaster Management Operation, Funding and Management of Disaster Assistance, and the Role of International Institution and Non-Government Foreign Institution in Disaster Management. Furthermore, there are local disaster management agencies established in 33 provinces and more than 80% districts in Indonesia. These agencies are to support the implementation of 5-year National Disaster Management Plan. It was initiated to identify the disaster risk across the nation and provide a reference for related institutions to minimize the risks and the impact of disaster in integrated, coordinated, and comprehensive steps. In Indonesia, DRR policies and programs are considered inter-sustainable development strategies with particular focus on disaster prevention, preparedness, and mitigation. To strengthen local government on this issue, it is important to build a resilient community with proper knowledge on basic survival skills and the necessary steps to minimize the impact of disaster. Honorable delegates, it is projected that natural disaster in Indonesia will be most affected by climate change. The rise of sea level has caused coastal flooding in several cities and islands and been threatening marine biodiversity. More than 16 million people in 8,000 coastal villages in Indonesia will be much affected by the harsh climate condition. Therefore, Indonesia is deeply concerned on regional partnership in DRR. My fellow parliamentarians, since 2006, Indonesia has launched a number of capacity-building initiatives, including strengthening human resources in disaster management as a key element. Supportive efforts are also exercised to enhance the research and development of early warning system of tsunami, flood, volcanic eruption, earthquake, landslide, forest fire, and through hazard initiated by the national agency, including to integrate DRR into school curriculum. Indonesia has also introduced a mechanism in support of disaster preparedness and recovery. The Indonesia Multi-Donor Fund Facility for disaster recovery was established to help the implementation of rehabilitation and reconstruction plans. Nevertheless, the government of Indonesia acknowledged that disaster preparedness in Indonesia is different from one area to another. Therefore, continuous research and considerable support from our international partners are truly necessary to improve our national capacity for DRR. Tabe, terima kasih, muchas gracias.
Muchas gracias a Indonesia. Tiene la palabra.